live draft.
Driving? Look like we're parked to me.
Cool.
Everybody, I'm Mag Davis, your host for Road Trip After Hours. And of course, every week, my co-host, Mr. Teddy Long, WWE Hall of Famer. How you doing, Teddy?
I'm doing good. You know, I'm telling you, the more I work with you, the more I try to figure out, am I with a human being or am I with an avatar? I just have no idea.
Also with us now is Angel Orsini. She is the co-founder of the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame. She's a multi-sport athlete, holds a master's degree from Rutgers University. She is a black belt in Taekwondo and a professional wrestler for over 20 years, trained by Liz Chase and none other than Dusty Rhodes. Hello.
Hey, how you doing? It's great to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. Teddy, met you, I guess, about a week or two ago, and y'all got to talking about the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame.
Well, let me say this, before we get into that. I've met Angel, man. Me and Angel, I've known Angel over 10 years. I guess it hasn't really been that long. And I met Angel on the indie scene in Georgia and everything, man. And so the first time I saw her, she had this impact. You know, it was like when you seen China come to the ring, you seen something. You know what I mean? You knew you were in for a fight. And that's how Angel has always portrayed herself. For you people that have not had the opportunity to see her in the ring, she looks absolutely great. And she has a presence. And all that means something in wrestling. You have to have a presence. So when you saw Angel walking down, then you knew, you, like I said, you were in for a fight. And she's been such a sweetheart, man, all over the years. She had a chance to go out and hang with some other people that I know really well. And you do too, Mac, Mac and Jazz. And so, and like I said, I've seen Angel like a week ago and it was like, wow, man, this is outstanding to be able to, link back up with her. And I'm going to tell you, Blair, she still looks the same. In fact, now I think she looks better than she was back there when I first saw her.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, so I just wanted to, give Angel, the opportunity. She talked to me a little bit this past Saturday and let me know what she was involved in. And so I said, hey, let's talk about it, because I'm like this. If I can help you in any way I can, then that's what I want to do, because she's always been a sweetheart.
Well, Angel, we're talking about the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame, members that include Luna Vachon, Medusa. Let's see, the actual show Glow is also somebody in there. Missy Hyatt and a whole lot more. Can you tell us about the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame and how this started?
Yes, I am a co-founder along with Christopher Anino, ECW original Gary Wolf, and Susan Tex Green, who's been a dear friend of mine for over 20 years. And we decided that it was really important for women's wrestling, now that it's growing to the level that it is, that we educate people on the history of women's wrestling, right? It shouldn't everybody know the classic women of wrestling, not just only Mildred Burke and Leilani Kai and Joyce Grable and Judy Martin. Of course, they should know them, and Moolah and May, but what about the first African-American lady wrestlers? Babs Wingo, Ethel Johnson, Marva Scott. These women, and give what their accomplishments were some context, right? Being a woman of color in the 60s and wrestling, when people had separate bathrooms for black and white people, even separate water fountains. And these women were out there during this time.
That's a tough time. And of course, just the society itself was tough enough, but in that business too. I mean, they're fighting two different fights at the same time.
Indeed they were. And you can say what you want about Billy Wolf, but NWA brought those women around this country during that time and displayed their talents, and they deserved it, bar none. So we're inducting those women, and a lot of people might not know it, but they were sisters.
Wow.
So they're going to be inducted this year. Yeah. And, of course, our first inductees were Jazz and Medusa and Luna Vachon. And,
yeah, I told Teddy when we talked about you coming on, I said, I think Jazz is in that Hall of Fame, because I remember seeing something towards the end of last year. I think it was somewhere around there that I saw a piece about Jazz. And I remember that the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame was working with another Hall of Fame that Teddy and I will be actually hosting their event, which is the International Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame. I believe they worked together to get a couple of things maybe to you guys or something along those lines. I believe there was some kind of work between the two, but it's a great organization, that you have, mainly because it does focus on women, especially in a sport where a lot of men tend to be the focus. But the women now today are just as athletic as they, as the guys are. Do you see women's wrestling having progressed quite a bit since you started?
Absolutely. I mean, when I was working with Teddy, I was wrestling men, and that was innovative at the time. Nobody was doing it. And I ended up being the hardcore champion because the people loved it. And that actually in part is how I got into ECW. So, imagine there was none of that going on to now there's organizations where it's totally intergender wrestling.
Yes.
And so, yeah, I love it. This is exactly what it needed to be 15 years ago.
Correct.
But I'm grateful to have it now. And that's why we're launching this now, so that it helps educate people and brings a little bit more spotlight and shine to the women that are there now, so that we keep these platforms running and keep encouraging younger women to get involved and get trained and carry on the tradition. That's why I'm still doing it now.
Tell me how people can get involved with the organization, how they can help either through donations or just going to the website.
Yes, go to the website. Absolutely. Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame.com, all spelled out. Contact us at Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame at Gmail. And we are also doing a documentary on the history of women's professional wrestling called Circle of Champions. And we are looking for people to donate to that. We do have a GoFundMe on the website there for that, because we're going to be entering that film into some film festivals, because it is noteworthy. There's a lot of legends that we captured their interviews, and it is their last interview. So wrestling fans of all the diverse types and kinds are going to love this film and appreciate it. So, and also Jazz is very involved in that film. So,
I think we all three love Jazz. There's no doubt about that. In fact, Teddy, when I mentioned that, he says, yeah, I think she actually has an association with Jazz.
Yeah.
Well, yes. Yeah, we were in ECW together, and we were rivals in ECW, and now we're best friends. I mean, she is a wonderful person, and what they're doing down in Texas, her and Rodney have Dog Pound Dojo. Yes, and so people who are located in San Antonio, Texas, should definitely check out their school, because if you want to be trained in pro wrestling, I mean, that's where it's at. And it really has like that family vibe. It's very supportive, everyone. So I definitely encourage people to check them out. Absolutely.
Well, Angel, we appreciate you being on the show. We hope that everybody will stop by that website, do whatever you can to make sure this organization sticks around because it needs to be here. This is a fantastic group. Again, it's the Women's Wrestling Hall of Fame, and the website is what?
Women'sWrestlingHallOfFame.com.
All right. Thank you so much, Angel.
Thank you for having me, gentlemen.
Also, you know, I wanted to mention this too. You know, she was talking about, you know, Dog Pound Championship Wrestling with Rodden and Jazz, you know, and they've become so big down there now that they've expanded their group and they're part of TSW, Texas Style Wrestling also. Yes. So let's also remind them about Texas Style Wrestling because Dog Pound and those are combined and both organizations are doing really great.
Yeah, we've been a part of Texas Style Wrestling last year. Look forward to going back and seeing them again sometime this year. And for the next couple of minutes, we're going to take a commercial break. But then we'll be right back with a little bit more and then Ask Teddy next.
The show starts in 2 minutes.
Hey, Mom. Yes, you. Why fuss and fret about dinner? Why not have it right here? Yes, this drive-in offers everyone in the family a real picnic treat for dinner. We've got delicious sandwiches with all the trimmings and your other dinner favorites, plus whatever you want to drink, hot or cold. Come early before the show starts, or eat while you're being entertained, or at intermission time. So why fuss? Give your family a tasty dinner at this drive-in.
And we're back with more Road Trip After Hours. I'm your host, Mac Davis, along my co-host, the one, the only WWE Hall of Famer, holla, holla, Teddy Long. Hey, Teddy.
Holla back at you.
You know, other day I was talking to you about movies. I think we were doing the Ask Questions the other day, and I was asking about movies. And you said you didn't really watch many movies. And that kind of surprised me. So I wanted to bring up a few names of movies and see if you remember any of these movies and your thoughts about them, because they're pretty prominent. Let's see if you remember any of them. Jaws.
Never saw it.
Never saw Jaws.
No.
Oh, brother, let me tell you something. That movie, if anybody has never seen Jaws, it's that one movie. If you love the beach, don't watch it. Once I watched that movie, I was terrified to go back out in that ocean.
Well, I remember it. You know, I remember seeing clips of it doing when they were showing maybe it being advertised and stuff, but I never really sat down, you know, and watched the whole movie. I never had that time to do that. You know what I mean? I was on the road all the time, and the little time that I did have, I was trying to get some sleep. Yep.
Another one of those movies, Teddy, is Friday the 13th. Did you ever watch one of those?
I saw a little bit of it. That was with Jason. Yeah. I saw a little bit of that.
Yeah, that bothered me a little bit, too. Now, how about Star Wars?
Never saw that.
No. Or do not. There is no try.
Wow. Teddy, we're going to have to get you in front of some TV, let you watch some really good movies, because these are great movies. Let me ask you about a few more. And when I say great movies, that does not include the following movies I'm about to mention. No Holds Barred with Hulk Hogan from 1989. Did you watch that one?
I saw a little bit of that, but I don't all remember. You know, I mean, it wasn't too bad. It was most of it was kind of comical a little bit. A lot more comedy, you know. But, yeah, I did see a little bit of that.
Yeah, that was like super campy to me. It was like watching an episode of Batman back in the 60s.
Are you looking for a little escape? Want to see something?
This is sick!
You don't see every day. Are you ready for a whole new Hulk Hogan? Hulk Hogan is ripped. To the world, he's a hero. But to this man, he's history. Zeus. Stand back. Way back. Get ready for the battle no ropes can hold. No ring. No referee. No rules.
Gentlemen, it's time.
No holds barred.
Let's see. Ready to Rumble. Were you there during that time when WCW produced that movie with, it had David Arquette and I can't remember the other guy's name.
Diamond Dallas Page was in it.
Yes, Sting. John Cena was in that movie.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, John Cena was an extra in the background of a gym for that movie, which is one of his first appearances.
Buenos nachos.
I didn't know you spoke Spanish.
Yeah, I took it in high school a bunch of times. She's the nitro's nitro girl of them all.
It's my dream girl, bro.
I got your poster up in my room.
Which one?
It's this one.
I never did see that either. Well, in fact, I don't even think I was in WCW when they did that.
Beyond the Mat. Have you seen that movie? Now, that's one you should see. That's one that, of all the ones I've mentioned, Teddy, that really is a good, good documentary-style thing about wrestling. It talks about Mick Foley, Terry Funk, and Jake Roberts, and kind of goes behind the scenes, and it's brutally honest.
Yeah.
The other one is The Wrestler. Were you a part of
it? I did see that, Mickey Rourke.
Yeah. What did you think about that movie?
Not too bad. Yeah, it was, all right. I had a chance to meet him, too, in person, too. He was at one of the shows. I can't remember where we were, but, such a nice guy.
Yep.
And like I said, man, I mean, for him not to know anything about wrestling in the wrestling business and for him to go all the way back to the back in the day like it really was, you know what I mean, yep. And pull that off, I thought it was outstanding. Yeah, I thought he did a good job.
I thought he did super in that movie.
Yeah, all because right. That's how guys still live as of today, some of the indie guys, man. They wrestle on the weekend, then go do a real job, during the week, and then drive and trying to struggle to make it big back and forth, So that was real.
And not able to give up that persona is also a part of that. He just couldn't let that character leave.
Really good, you really brought it.
Thank you.
You hang in there, you got a lot of ability.
Have you ever seen a one-trick pony and feel so happy and free?
I was wondering if I could get some more work.
All I got is weekends. Isn't that when you sit on other dudes' faces?
Have you ever seen a one-legged dog?
Have a beer with me? One beer.
You have a daughter?
Oh, my daughter. She don't like me very much.
You should call her.
And you seen me?
What do you want from me?
I'm an old, broken-down piece of meat, and I deserve to be all alone. I just don't want you to hate me.
You seen me?
Two words. Three. Match.
Bring it. With a little luck, this could be my ticket back on top.
Tell me, friend, can you ask for anything?
80s, man, best ever.
Guns N' Roses.
Crew.
Yeah, then that Cobain had to come around and ruin it all.
90s sucked.
These things that have comforted me, I drive away. My only faith's in the broken bones and bruises I display.
The only place I get hurt is out there.
I'm really here.
This life, you lose everything you love, everything that loves you. A lot of people told me that I'd never wrestle again. The only one who's going to tell me when I'm through doing my thing is you people here.
Now, what do you think? What do you think about this?
That'll work.
Come here.
All right, let's go into the mailbag, Teddy. It's time to ask Teddy.
Letters. Oh, we get letters. We get your letters every day. Mailbag. pen and pull one out. Those letters, I love those letters. Let's find out what you've got to say.
Oh boy!
Mailman, mail today.
All right, Teddy, it's time for question number one. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Blair.
All right, here we go. Billy in North Carolina. There's been a lot of talk of a referee going into the WWE Hall of Fame. Who do you think it should be?
Well, I'm not going to speak on that because it's two or three referees that I think should be in there. It's more than one. So I don't want to be, you know, just in the middle of that. So like I said, all I can say about that is it's about time. And whoever it is that is going to the Hall of Fame, congratulations to him. And boy, and I wish him all the best.
All right. Scott in Texas wants to know, where did the WWE go to find the hose for the Godfather's hoe train?
Well, I don't know. That was through our talent relations department. So they made the call and found the girls, but I have no idea where they got them from.
I can make a guess where they got them from just based on the appearance and how they handled themselves in the ring. But
they probably called the local strip club and just say, hey, you girls want to make some extra money? We'd like you to use it on our TV show. You know, come down, sign this non-disclosure, and get a check and keep on going.
What a hard job. You have to go out there with a bunch of pretty women behind you and just go out there and have fun. Oh, that's
just outstanding.
All right. Teresa in Utah. She's got a marry, date, or dump thing for you, which basically I'll give you three names and you tell me who you would marry, who you would date, and who you would dump. You ready?
Okay.
Mariah Carey, Beyonce, and Madonna.
I would dump Madonna. I would marry Beyonce, and what was the other one?
Date Mariah
Carey.
You better have a lot of that, Blue Chew stuff with you when you do that. All right, let's see.
I live with that. That's part of me.
Amen, brother.
So you don't take it because you have to. You take it because you can.
That's right. Because you want it, you know. All right.
Well,
let's see.
You go from regular to premium gas. You put premium gas in your car, it runs a lot better. You put regular.
That's right. All right. Here's the other list of names they give you. Now, the first one was kind of easy. Let's see how you do with this one. Marry, date, or dump Vicky Guerrero, Stephanie McMahon, and Crystal Marshall.
I'd probably date Vicky Guerrero, and I'd probably marry Stephanie McMahon just to make her mad.
Hey, look here at our age, man. If you're looking at who you're going to marry and who you're going to date, I'm looking at who's got the money.
And the other person there, Crystal Marshall, I would just date.
Got you. All right. Terry from Facebook asks, I plan on placing a bet on WrestleMania this year. Who do you think I should go with? Doink or Hornswoggle?
Doink.
Doink, really? You worked with Hornswoggle some, didn't you?
Yeah, I worked with him but a little bit, man. He's a character.
I hear he's kind of a prankster, too.
Well, but they stopped all that. Undertaker put him in his place about all them pranks one time. So I never
did.
Yeah, well, we was doing this skit one time about St. Patrick's Day or something, and he messed around. They had to send out and get the real beer. So he ended up drinking the real beer, and the next thing we know, he's drunk. So Taker takes him and puts him on a luggage cart or something. I don't know what it was, and just pushed him around out in the parking lot or did something with him.
Oh, boy. Let's see. I got one more question, and we're running out of time. Let's see. Alex Podcast Network from Twitter asks, any memories of when Titus O'Neil puked in JBL's hat and on Zeb Coulter?
Well, that was just nasty.
And you could tell somebody, that looked like one of those things that maybe Vince enjoys and he put together. Am I right?
Exactly.
Yeah. That's what I figured. Teddy, anything coming up we need to talk about before we close out of here?
No, I think everything's good, you know, for a while right now until, you know, we'll be next, what is it? Well,
May 13th.
Not here yet, so yep. I'll be letting you know more about April. I have been talking with some people. They just hadn't confirmed, but also just a big deal that's coming up for me and you on April the 12th in St. Louis.
May, May 13th.
Going to be a big event there.
May 13th.
I mean, May 13th. God,
I'm going to stamp that on your head.
Yeah, please. I'm going to have to make a note and put it to me when I'm doing this thing so I can remember these dates. Okay.
I can just see you now calling me up going, Mac, where the hell are you? We got to get on the airplane. Like, that's next month, Teddy.
You know, that just happened to me. I think I told you when I was going to ECW this past weekend, and my Delta thing went off and told me about the check in. I'm like, check in for what? So I look at my phone. I'm like, oh, God, I forgot about the show. So this was on the next day before I had to fly out, so
it's not easy.
My packing is not too bad, not worrisome. I just only carry little stuff, so I got myself together and went on to Philadelphia.
All right, folks, that's it. We're out of time. I'm knocking lights everywhere too. I'm Mac Davis, your host, and that is your co-host, Mr. WWE Hall of Famer Teddy Long, and we'll see you next week.
Holla.